Hey everybody, Cassie and Matt McBean here with CIR Realty. Cassie and Matt Real Estate, just wanted to pop on quick and give you your May update and talk about a little bit about what's going to be happening in the real estate market here in June. So what we saw in May was quite a bit of activity actually. We had lots of sales happening, almost double what was happening in April across the different markets, and in some cases nearly three times as many sales happening versus what was going on back in April. Down still from 2019, but really encouraging to see, even with COVID still going on, that we've got activity happening, sales are still happening, and the market isn't falling apart. Prices are holding pretty strong, so we're going to go through a few of the specifics here, and Cassie will give you an update after that. So for the Calgary real estate market, there was about just over 1,000 sales that occurred in May, and that was down 44% from 2019 in the same month, but up quite a bit from the month before. And 2,400 new listings came on the market in Calgary as well. The average days on market across the city is around 60 days on market, so not terrible. You know, that varies a little bit by a specific neighborhood, and certainly if you're interested in any of that, please feel free to reach out and we'd be happy to talk about that with you. And then for Okotoks, we saw about 45 sales in May, which was almost double the month before and nearly three times what it was the month before. So yeah, really great news story there. It was down 37% from May of 2019, but still really encouraging to see that. We were even in a situation where we were in competing offers on a property in Okotoks, so there's definitely a lot of traffic, lots of showings happening in that area, and just lots of general overall activity. 65 new listings came on in May, and about 65 days on market was the average there. So for High River, we had 24 sales, so double what we had in April, only down about 20% from May of 2019, and 29 new listings came on the market, and about 65 days on market is the average in High River right now that we're looking at. So still really, really good news story there. And when we look at, you know, all of the markets that we're working in a lot, what we're seeing in terms of the comparison between the sales price and the list price is that those are generally selling within, you know, 2 to 4% of where they're listed at. So we're not seeing that there's a significant reduction in market value due to COVID-19 like many people were expecting. And if you subscribe to our client update, you'll be getting an email with a few more details about what we're seeing and what we expect to see. But of course, we don't have crystal balls, so we won't get too much into the details. But the story right now is that market values have held pretty steady, and we're not seeing any really abnormal discounts in most cases. That being said, there's still great deals to be had out there. There are people that need to sell, and you know, interest rates are really advantageous. So I'll let Cassie talk a little bit about that, and yeah, pass it off to Cassie.
Absolutely. Thank you for joining us this morning here, folks. Really appreciate that. In talking to a few of our mortgage lenders this week, essentially what's happened is the qualifying rate has decreased. So if you were somebody that had tried to apply for a mortgage early on in 2020, now if you were to go to re-qualify, the chances are you would be able to possibly qualify for a little bit more. So if you weren't quite there with what you wanted to spend earlier this year, I'd recommend trying it again with your lender or mortgage broker. And if you need suggestions for who to work with there, we've got a handful of lenders and mortgage brokers here that we work with locally in the markets that we service. So that's excellent news. And as Matt said, the interest rates remain low, so still super affordable to make that mortgage payment and get into home ownership. So that's really good thing there. Also kind of what's happening in our world here this afternoon, we're doing a showing Thursday and then another one Friday, so our showings have been happening during the week, so we're out and about with that, and you'll see the showing traffic is still increasing every week. There's more and more folks out shopping to buy their home, so that's exciting. And then also a good news story, we got the final sign-offs this morning for our new acreage listing. So we'll have a new acreage coming on here later next week with about 20 acres on it. And then there's a house and a garage that comes with it. And we're going to be under $400,000 for that. That's going to be out in the the Vulcan County out near Milo, Alberta. So if you know where that is, that's an area that we also service and know very well ourselves too. So that's a new one coming on, and then we're going to continue on with the virtual open houses. So CIR's got an amazing network here where we're able to access some different listings that are new to us, and go ahead with the virtual open house style of open houses to show you some new and different products that are on the market and in different markets out there for you. So if you join in and view those with us, that's absolutely great. And if you've got any questions about them or anything about your market that you're wondering about, or just what's on your mind these days, definitely feel free to message us or send us a text or call either one of us. That's absolutely fabulous.
Yeah, for sure. Please feel free to reach out with any questions anytime, and contact information will be in the post. And we look forward to chatting with you soon. Thanks, everybody. Have a great day.